iMovie's interface has 5 visible areas and 1 hidden area. Think of them as 4 corners and a strip through the middle. Up here in the upper left, we have the project browser. The upper right, we have the viewer. The lower right, we have the event browser. And the lower left, we have the event library. The strip right through the middle is called the toolbar. The hidden area is up here behind the project browser, and it's called the project library. If you see this little tab right here called project library, just click on it and the project library will be visible. This is a list of all the different projects that you have on your computer. To select a project, you can highlight it and then click on edit project, or simply double click the project. Now that I've told you what the areas are, let me describe their purpose. First of all, up here in the upper left is the project browser. This is where your movie's actually built. This is iMovie's timeline. It contains these dotted rectangles that you will replace by clips once you start assembling your movie. The area hidden behind this project browser is the project library. And as I said before, this contains all the projects created in iMovie and that are currently being stored on your computer. The upper right is the viewer. This is where clips play back. And to play a clip back, just move your mouse, or what we call a playhead, to the particular clip, and then just press the space bar to start play, and press the space bar to stop play. The event browser down here, this is where you view original source clips after they've been assigned to an event and successfully imported into iMovie. The event library is this area over here in the lower left, and it displays events by date or event. And to access, just click on them individually, and the clips stored in the event will be shown in the event browser. The final area is the toolbar, and this is the strip right through the middle, and it contains buttons to perform the most commonly used functions, and then also to access media down here in the far right. The type of media each of these buttons accesses is represented by the button's icon. So you have music, still images, titles, transitions, and maps, backgrounds, and animatics. Now, to ensure that you're seeing every tool possible on the toolbar, go to the menu bar across the top of the screen and click iMovie, then Preferences, and make sure that you are on this General tab right here, and then that Show Advanced Tools is checked.